Good morning, yep. Everyone.
Now,
wow, that's fancy.
Things you can do 5 o'clock in the morning. How you doing, Jeremiah?
I'm doing fine. I'm a little winded. It was a this plan of, hey, this will be a nice, easy Mando Monday, turned into a, hey, there's other cool stuff that Jeremiah is going to need some assistance with. And that's why we're starting in the parking lot of all places.
The place where you're not allowed to show your camera.
No, we're allowed to do this. It's just not security. It's just the temperature check.
Okay. One of these days you're going to go up there and then this will be the shortest Disney Parks Life talk ever.
Sorry, sir. You need to put that away. Yes.
So hello everybody. Welcome to Disney Park Walk and Talk. Today we are at an almost park. We're at Disney Springs with the one and only Jeremiah. Say hi, Jeremiah.
Hi, Jeremiah.
And my name is Doobie. I am sitting here in the air-conditioned Laughing Place headquarters. Jeremiah, I imagine the weather for you is pretty similar to air conditioning.
It is kind of chilly today. Things I have not said in about a year.
Really? Wow.
My roommate made fun of me this morning because I'm not wearing pants.
Are you going to get kicked out for other reasons?
Oh, no, I'm wearing shorts, just not pants.
Oh, okay. A little concern there. So I'd like to remind you all that we are 100% live, because if we weren't, we certainly would not have started in a parking lot. So that means if there's anything you'd like to see, anything you want us to show you, any questions for me, Jeremiah, any cool tricks you'd like them to perform, please let us know in the comments. We'll do our best to accommodate you. Also, like to ask you to please do us a huge favor and like the stream, whoever you're watching. Yeah, subscribe to our channel. If you're on YouTube, ring the bell so you get notified when we go live, which we do a lot. And with that, welcome to Disney Springs with Jeremiah. Where the crowds are, how would you describe them, Jeremiah?
They're like crowded. I mean, it is 11:03, 11:04 on Monday, and
it's 12:04.
Oh, sorry, I hadn't changed my clock. for a noon crowd on a Monday, it's actually a little bit busier than I've seen down here. Mando Monday brings people down here.
Looks very nice. I love Disney Springs. Palm trees. People are doing some early morning buying. I'm seeing lots of bags as well.
Yes, and we're actually walking into the first sign of the holiday season here at Disney Springs.
You mean Christmas has come to Disney World?
Christmas came to Disney World at 12:01 on November 1st.
That's nice. Very nice.
Go ahead.
Jingle Cruise debuted at Disney World at Magic Kingdom, and all the decor is up there. So Christmas has definitely come to Disney World. Doesn't take long.
And speaking of didn't take long, sadly, Lucky Brand closed overnight a few days ago.
So, What was it?
Clothing brand.
Okay.
Yeah.
There's plenty of clothes in Disney Springs.
That's one of the things about this area is there's so many little clothing shops, you know, especially for you and I, because we're not big shoppers. Shops have come and gone, and we're like, oh, yeah, I remember that, kind of.
Is Uniqlo still in Disney Springs?
I'm sorry?
Uniqlo?
Yes.
Cool. We should make our way over there. Yeah, we should make our way over there. I hear they might have some cool new merchandise for us to check out.
Absolutely. We're heading to someplace particular.
That's fine. We're along the ride.
Looks like there, and you can, if you can, there is a windy all day here at Disney Springs.
We can most definitely hear that. You need to take some of that stabilizer budget and put it into a windscreen.
Well, that's the problem with the windscreen on this is I can either do the windscreen or I can do the ear pods. And
go left. Go see that thing. That is my single favorite part of Disney Springs.
I was looking more at the light towers that are going to be here for the Christmas tree that'll be here shortly.
Is the Christmas tree going to block my favorite thing?
It'll block your favorite view of it from the other side. Do you know what your favorite thing is called?
No. What is it called?
It is called an Archimedes screw.
Very cool.
It was designed to bring water uphill, and we do have two young ladies that are turning and turning and turning. So there comes the water that's being brought uphill.
Am I correct? It was named after Dr. Albert Screw?
Yes. Yep, that just took care of me for the day.
Control yourself, Jeremiah.
So here's another fun store, archaeology.
You may not have pronounced that right.
I see A and ology, so.
Anthropology. It's like all these stores, it's like walking through Walnut Creek.
Looks like we still have the Haunted Mansion merchandise.
Jeff Schenkel. He's in our Jungle Cruise mode. The backwash of water. That's pretty disgusting.
Yes, it is. Most of the, I believe 99% of the stores down here have reopened.
Very good. Yeah, are there any notable stores or restaurants that still haven't?
Toomey hasn't opened. As far as I've seen, and every time I've come down here, it has not reopened. It may have reopened during times when I'm not here, but that would be strange.
Are all of the restaurants reopened as far as you know?
I'm doing a checklist in my head. Yes. Yeah, everything is pretty open.
Good.
Here we have Under Armour. A very good shop if you ever want to come to Disney Springs and get some dragon fighting clothing.
I've seen you pump an iron, and that's what you wear.
Yeah. Okay, we're going to see how far we can make it through Uniqlo.
Yeah, I hear what we're looking for might be near one of the entrance doors. Don't stray too far.
It is actually the center of this store. Where they have the main portion of it. They do have, I know what Stat Princess was referring to, and they have a small area over there, but this is
why you're the expert.
I mean.
Oh, wow. Can you name all seven?
Yes. There's Maleficent. Can you see that one?
That's disgusting. I no, that's disgusting.
She is actually purple, but the lighting is showing her as white, much like Spaceship Earth. People think that it's white, but it's actually gold.
It's actually,
or silver.
It's actually white. Those are cute.
Hey, I feel like Benji should be wearing these.
So So I think all of these just came out. Wow, I love that Steamboat Willie. These are very recent, maybe even today releases.
Nope.
No? Some of them. Some of these.
This is super cute.
You like the Japanese stuff?
Yes. Here is Princess Songs. One of the great things about Uniqlo is they have so much merchandise that comes out. You can walk in here and find something new every time.
So the ones we're looking for that were just released, I believe today, none of these fall in that category. Maybe they are near the entrance, or maybe they just haven't been put out yet. But if we see them, I'll point them out. Now that I've got them in front of me.
Is that one? Is that one?
No.
No, not that one.
I mean, those are pointing out, but that's not what I'm looking for. A really nice Dumbo shirt.
I will head to where it says New Arrival.
Novel concept. Hey. Not sure about that one. The one next to it, though?
This one or that one?
The other next to it?
This one?
That is a brand new shirt. Do you see a Dumbo shirt there with flags?
Yes, but I do.
And that one there, that Pooh shirt.
That is okay. Really cute.
Yeah.
Oh, Mr. Ruck steps out.
I like the Dumbo, too. That one's really cool. So, yeah, we found the new stuff now. We get there. Morning, Sparkles.
Stat Princess was correct. It is near one of the previous entrances, but it is now only an exit.
So you are now learning a lesson that I learned years and years ago.
Can you guys hear me? Did I pop in?
Yes, you did.
Can you show what the price is on those t-shirts for me?
$19.90.
Thank you.
Yep.
Available in double XS, double extra small, all the way up to 3XL.
This is a cool one.
And also want to let people know that those are mostly available on Uniqlo.com and then in very few of their stores. So Uniqlo.com, the store at Disney Springs, and I think they're on Fifth Avenue, their New York location. But other than that, mostly online.
Thank you. So yes, these are the new things, and now you have seen them straight from Uniqlo. You can purchase them online, or you can make your way down to Disney Springs.
Look at this stuff.
Say hi to,
isn't it neat?
Say hi to Jeremiah if you do.
Hi to Jeremiah. Okay, we are heading to where the goal was direct from our CEO first thing this morning.
Okay. I'm excited to see what that is.
Amorettes. Excuse me, I'm just going to take this from you there, miss.
Is this the wrapping paper,
Are you not alone there, Jeremiah? Oh, that is slightly disturbing.
There we go.
So that is a mini dome cake inspired by the child. Is that Amorettes?
That is Amorettes.
It's cookies and cream filling, and it's limited to 40 cakes per day on sale through November 30th, but only 40 per day. So I want to look. Are you going to eat it? Take a bite. Let us know how it is. Or your partner.
Hang on. Let me walk over there. How much was this?
$9.
This was a $9 cake.
It better be really, really, really good.
Hey, they in hang on, let me.
And then someone's actually asked you to do a trick like we always invite people to do, but we'll wait for you to do your tasting.
Okay, getting ready.
Okay, this is very exciting.
Hang on, I'm taking a couple of pictures.
This is extremely meta right now.
Okay, so we're ready for this?
Yep, cookies and cream, inspired by the child from, what's the name of the place again?
Amaretz.
Amaretz.
What part should I eat, Doobie?
I always say you eat the mouth first, so when you eat the other parts of them, you can't hear him scream.
He doesn't have a mouth, so I'm going to get one of his eyes.
Okay. We've heard the baby Yoda talk now, and that's not what he sounds like. Hey, yo, this is kind of painful.
Also, this is kind of difficult with one hand.
Noticing. All right.
Okay, hang on. We're going to... No, I'm not going to do this live.
While you eat, can we get a good shot of the inside of that? See what it looks like? See what baby Yoda's insides look like? That's beautiful. Cookies and cream.
It is very tasty.
It is. What does the outside taste like? Is that a key lime?
It is very like a key lime type. But
okay. You don't have to eat it all. We don't have to watch Jeremiah have his whole meal.
Mm.
All right, so $8 was the price again?
$9.
$9 at Amaretz through November 30th. However, limited to 40 cakes per day. One per transaction while supplies last at Disney Springs. The child.
The child.
Thank you, and thank you to whomever helped you with that.
That was my often shadow Michaela, not often shadow Shelley or often shadow... that was the biggest challenge today was, you know, the concern of it's the first day, 40 cakes. How do you get here? So
thank you, Michaela, for your assistance very much.
Right now I could definitely go for something to drink. I'm very much like parched because of the cookies and cream. And now I think we move on to our second Mando Monday. Nope, still the same Mando Monday.
Okay.
Unless at afternoon.
Whenever you're ready, it's going to be on that side.
Thank you.
There he is, still there.
Actually, this one is a different one.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I believe so. Yeah, this one looks much deeper than the other one did.
How does he taste?
Please do not touch.
Ooh. Look.
Free exclusive Han Solo carbonite keychain with purchase of $100 or more.
Yeah. You need anything?
Well, I have to be a VIP, and
sorry, I couldn't find the mute fast enough. We did have a request
when that happens
to perform a trick. Gideon Mosley, I believe it's pronounced, says, "Can you please do a trick? The trick I want you to do is to tell the stream that Disney Trivia Live is tomorrow."
Disney Trivia Live is tomorrow.
7:30 p.m. Pacific time.
Do we have a topic?
Nope. Disney Trivia.
And by Disney, you mean the umbrella of Disney, not just
yes, the parks. Yes, and that umbrella sometimes includes Universal. But okay. if you missed last Saturday's contest, our 50th, we had a special guest, Baby Yoda, and it was quite entertaining.
Yeah, remember those days when you're just going to the Santa Ana's or kicking in and you're like walking and fighting? It's kind of how I feel right now.
We feel you, Jeremiah. It's very clear. Do any of the stores here tend to have virtual waits?
On the weekends, World of Disney and the Co-op have done the virtual waits. But I want to say the last time I had any friends that came down here. Also, if you happen to see a water fountain, can you point that out to me? The last time my friends came down here, I'm also trying to get into the shop as quick as possible. They didn't have the virtual wait for World of Disney. They just had a very long queue.
Seems like a good day to focus on indoor activities.
Yeah. So I'm guessing since I'm walking all the way around to the back side, there is a queue to get in on a Monday at noon 23 or whatever time it is.
There is a queue?
Yeah.
Just a few reminders. Face coverings must fully cover your nose and mouth.
Oh, wow.
Should be worn at all times, except when active.
Is Basin still there? Oh, there it is.
Since I'm seeing other websites in line, I'm guessing that Christmas stuff has definitely gone on display, which is one of our focuses, besides the Mandalorian Monday event.
How long is this queue?
I am still walking.
Wow.
It seems to be moving pretty fast, so I think we should be able to entertain. We could do a little pre-trivia here.
Yeah, we'll figure something out. It's just...
And remember, all these queues do have social distance markers. So.
Right. I was just remembering the last time you showed up to a huge queue.
Oh, no. Yep. That will definitely go down as something that'll haunt me forever.
So, Jeremiah.
Yes, Doobie.
Do you prefer the current downtown Disney Springs or the last downtown Disney?
As in, when last downtown Disney are we talking?
Let's go to before the changes started at all. So Pleasure Island was still at its peak.
Oh, well, that's an easy one. Absolutely. I can explain, not just say, oh, absolutely, because Pleasure Island was there. No, back then, there were unique stores, too. It wasn't all, you know, World of Disney or a Star Wars store or a Marvel store. They had the old movie film vault that had posters, including, you know, one of our dinosaurs is missing poster or something unique like that. And just each store had its own personality where, and I think this is just the world we live in now where it's, this is a mall. Downtown Disney used to be a fun place to go and kind of enjoy. And it was an extension of the parks, not just a extension of your local shopping mall.
How about just in terms of atmosphere, decor? Because I agree with you on the shops, but I really like the way the current Disney Springs feels. What do you think?
It definitely, you know, if you came at night and when it was the old Downtown Disney, when Pleasure Island was still there and they actually had entertainment all across Downtown Disney, it was something nice. But during the day, it was very much, you know, you would walk and the marketplace would be open and then you would get to Pleasure Island and everything would be closed and then you'd get to the west side and then everything would be open.
Yeah, so, that's pretty funny.
I like the openness of everything. But
so trivia time. What was this area called when it first opened?
Is this a trivia to everybody or to
no, to
Jesse?
You, to Jeremiah?
The Lake Buena Vista Shopping Plaza? Shopping.
Not plaza.
District? No.
Ah, stumps Jeremiah. Village. Shopping village.
There we go.
And what year would that have been?
76?
Oh, close. 75. So you're over two.
Somewhere there.
And then they came with Pleasure Island in what year?
That one's easy. 89.
86. Man, you're bad. All right. Over three. Let's get off trivia.
I was actually talking about this. So the campaign runs October 1st through December. Toys for Tots. And they actually have a box here in the World of Disney.
Good. We'll need to remember to contribute next time.
Hold on. Pleasure Island was 86?
According to what I'm reading.
Because it opened with Disney's Hollywood Studios and Typhoon Lagoon.
Oh, wait a second. It is 1989. This is a bad number.
It was like, wait a second.
No, I'm sorry. I just read. I was trying to read and broadcast. It was announced in 86. It opened in 89. Yeah. Sorry.
That's always fun when you say something and my focus is someplace completely different. I'm like, wait.
And it was last question, it was created to compete with what?
That would be Church Street.
Yes. All right. That is adorable.
That is so cute.
Is it on merchandise or is it just...
They actually have plush and they have the ears. I'm not getting close to the ears because they have the mirror for it. But yeah. So let's head down to what was previously Halloween Central. And don't worry, if you've not purchased your 2020 merchandise, it is still buy one, get one free.
I'm excited to see the 2021 merchandise. It's always fun to see when's that first going to come on. Come out. Usually, not quite yet. I think it's usually right around the beginning of December we get the 2021s.
We've gotten the calendars out. And
that's always August, but that's a 16-month calendar. It starts in September, so that's not really a fair comparison.
Okay, we've showcased most of this merchandise on our site previously, but here is a good look at it all again.
Oh, make sure you get that picture. That is awesome.
Well, somebody just walked right in the way of it.
Please tell me it was Michaela.
No.
Really rude. That is really cool. Those little touches.
No, the person that walked in front of it, I also know. It is the Main Street Mouse. Michelle from the Main Street Mouse, another great site.
Cookies and milk for Santa. That's so cute.
Oh, this could rank up there as... It's a holiday baking set. Sorry for the glare.
And it comes with the cookies already baked?
No, I think those are the cookie cutters.
I was going to say, this is my kind of baking set.
There you go.
Big, huge fan of this look. That is
also
great.
Also, they're scented. $26.99.
They're scented?
Mm-hmm. So this entire area kind of smells like cinnamon and gingerbread.
Okay, that's heavenly sounding. I miss Disney World right now a lot.
So, if you had to guess what this is, Doobie.
It's not a mug? I guess it's a candle.
A candle.
Yay. Oh, and it smells like gingerbread. Can we get a good look at the thing on the top? Oh, snow balloon ear thingies. Peppermint, highly overrated candy.
I do agree on that. The only type of peppermint I like is a York peppermint patty.
Oh, you and my wife agree on that one.
You do not enjoy the York peppermint patties?
No, I'm not a mint fan at all.
Did you know York peppermint patty was named after the character from Peanuts?
Dr. Albert Patty?
Exactly.
No, really? That's the order that went? It was named after that? After
no. Peppermint patty dork. Was named after the peppermint.
Don't be a dork. I'm too gullible.
We're rotating.
Lots of red and green in the ceiling. That was a great rotation. Oh, can we see the castle? That is lovely. They need to sell that right there. And not full size, but a smaller size that.
Single face masks, $9.99 each.
Wow. How much are married ones?
The single ones just went up from $6 to $9.99.
Do they have any Christmas ones? Was that a Christmas one?
That was a Christmas one. Hang on. Okay. We're coming around. We're going to get a good view of the photo thing through the lens of... There we go. Look at back to the meta. We're getting a shot. Oh, now we're getting a discard. There we go. Look at that. Look at how pretty that is. And if you want to see that shot, me taking a picture of that shot, Main Street Mouse, go over there.
Wow. My wife is a superstar.
So now I want to find the other mask to see if they increase the price for all masks. There's the pajamas that we're all going to wear on Christmas morning.
So while you look for that mask, let me show off this real quick. I said they should sell that.
Did she grab my... Oh, yes.
$45 it is for sale.
Okay.
On Shop Disney and there. And it looks just like it. That is awesome.
Can you jump to the full screen? Forky peppermint candy cane plushes.
Forky may be the best Disney character in the past 15 years. Prove me wrong.
Oh, no. I completely agree. Forky is great.
And Soarin' is the best, second best Disney attraction since 2000.
I'm sorry, you broke up some there. Look, it's Christmas and Halloween. What happens when these two collide?
A movie that plays every year. Are you a fan of Nightmare?
I was. Hang on. This is a throwback to last night's. Remember this, Doobie?
No.
The picture from last night during our dig a little deeper. The Lights of Winter and Spaceship Earth.
Oh.
See, I told you it's back. If you're not sure what we're talking about, please go watch our dig a little deeper.
Yeah, my wife instantly knew what you meant. So, by the way, a lot of this merchandise you're looking at, Jeremiah has already, we put pictures up on Laughing Place. We do tons of merchandise updates on Laughing Place, both from the parks and just in general. And we always appreciate when you click our links when you buy, because we get a small referral fee that helps support us immensely.
Okay, let's see. No price tag.
But it's nouveau tissu.
I saw them in concert once. They're pretty good.
We watched Sorcerer's Apprentice last night, the live action. And there's one point where the guy says, "Are you in Depeche Mode? It made me so happy. My favorite group."
So, breaking news. Masks have jumped almost $4.
That is actually huge news. Make sure you get a tweet of that. That's a lot.
Oh, but we also have moved into some of the newer stuff. We have the Buzz Mask and the Jack and Sally and the It's a Small World. Looks like we got some Marvel characters. So, yeah, the masks that we had talked about arriving have arrived.
Along with a brand new price.
Yeah, that is a pretty big price jump. Normally, when we see price jumps, it's something we all kind of go, oh, okay, and then we understand. That is...
I kind of believe when those came out, I mean, it's a whole new category of product for them. They didn't really have a good handle on how much they should cost, and supply and demand comes into play. What are those, coasters?
Pins. These are the ones Mike showcased these a few days ago, but they have now arrived at World of Disney.
Are they pins of coasters?
Yes, and not the fun type of coasters.
And if you like Star Wars, please tune in 2-3.5 short hours for Mando Monday, our first post-premiere episode of Mando Monday, where they will be doing a deep dive into the first episode, The Marshall, as well as talking about a lot of the new merchandise released today. So Mando Monday, 1 p.m. Pacific time, right here. However you're watching us, that's where it'll be.
Okay, I think I'm going to exit the store, even though I think you may need these slippers, Doobie.
I refuse to wear shoes that expose my toes. That's one of my pet peeves.
You don't like toes? Do you have these?
I love those. I can't believe I've never bought them. How much are they? I remember they were $25 when I used to buy them. I used to see them.
Just $29.99. So these two,
in 10 years.
$4. Well, almost $5.
Just over the course of 10 years, though.
Okay, we're going to head out of here. I think I got everything, and then I'll come back in just a little bit for more pictures and fun. Oh, wait. Here is the different...
Oh, yeah. You get them all? Can you catch them all? We are... doing two jobs at once right here.
No Disney's Animal Kingdom, but we do have a holiday one that has, look, It's a Small World holiday on it.
Oh, which will be found nowhere this year.
Candlelight processional. This seems to be maybe for both coasts.
Jingle Cruise.
Because It's a Small World holiday, as far as I know, was not planned to come to Magic Kingdom. Although it may have been. And then there is the normal one. And, of course, the Epcot. And there's Disney's Hollywood Studios with the best DJ in the land featured front and center.
What's the dinosaur for? Oh, Rex. Never mind. I'm done.
Oh, yeah.
Michaela said, "That's so cute." I thought Michaela was with you.
Yeah. It's very meta. She's outside drinking Starbucks, I'm sure.
Hopefully she's getting you some water.
Oh, wait. Main attraction project release queue. Are we missing something in here?
Get on the case, Encyclopedia Brown.
Wow. I'm not even sure I could quote where that reference came from. Like that, what is that from?
Encyclopedia Brown. I mean, I didn't take it from a movie or anything. It is, you know Encyclopedia Brown?
Nope. That's why.
You don't know Encyclopedia Brown?
It registers in my head, but I don't know why it registers
in my head. It's just a series of kids' books about this, you know, investigating kid who solves cases.
Well, there we go.
Gideon had a face.
So, yes, I'm guessing that the Minnie's Main Attraction product queue may be for the co-op. So let's see if I'm going to stand in another queue.
Let's investigate.
This is the pure fun of the walk-in talk. Really, if you've not followed us on these, you are missing out. We dive deep into the lands of Magic Kingdom parks, and I don't know where I was going with that. I'm sorry.
Jeff appreciated Encyclopedia Brown for the win. By the way, Jeff, I hope you feel better. That picture is not good. You need to get a picture. Get me a picture of your gimbal of Ward when we're all done here, so he can finish your character.
Thank you for visiting us.
Okay, got it.
Just a few reminders. Face coverings must fully cover your nose.
This is the line for World of Disney. Now, see what happens when we broadcast live?
Everyone's following you.
But I still don't understand the product release queue for the main attraction.
Aren't you going to the co-op to investigate?
No, it's directing us down that way to the normal queue.
Sandra, do you know what this product is? What is it called? Mini what?
Mini main attraction. It's Minnie Mouse, the main attraction. It's the Haunted Mansion stuff from a few days ago that we covered at the Magic Kingdom.
Right.
So they must be releasing or have had some of the remnants still left.
Coming soon, Jungle Fun.
Yes, that is a very cute series.
Agreed.
Walking by Ghirardelli's and you just smell the waffle cone. Mm.
You prefer waffle cone to sugar cone?
I actually prefer the old Thrifty's cones.
Oh, dude. with the cylindrical scoops that you could top, like, stack 12 high.
You know that you can, every now and then, Thrifty's will sell those? The ice cream scoops? I may or may not have tried to get one quite a few times. But.
And I remember you used to be able to get 3 scoops of ice cream for 45 cents. It was like 25, 35, 45.
So
those days are gone.
I still can't get over this $9.99. did the price increase on Shop Disney too?
Oh, good point. Let me check that real quick.
These are some very cute posters.
Do they come framed? How much are they?
Framed, I want to say they are $3.99, but they have the deluxe print, and it is $39.99. But if you buy 2, it is just $30 each.
Someday, when I have a lot of money and a large home, that's one of the things I want to decorate with is a ton of attraction posters.
When you move back to Florida?
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, really. I love attract. I'm sorry. Answering my wife, who you can't see her questions. Yeah, really.
It's like, okay, I got the yeah. And then you just get, yeah, really. I can't believe you.
I'm trying to look up masks. So I'm seeing two pack. I have a problem just seeing a mask. So I see that's a Spirit jersey mask.
Oh, look at this.
So I'm gonna ask my assistant to help me out. Okay, so we don't see single mask, just ordinary single mask online, like the ones you're seeing that are $9.99 at all for sale. Congratulations.
But these are super cute.
Are those for a dog or a person?
Well, a dog.
I did not mean to click that button, but I did.
Hang on. Amazon thrifty ice cream scooper.
You can find the ice cream scooper on Amazon. Awesome. Thank you, Jeff.
Again, things that are just making this day so much better right now.
I want to get that.
Do you eat much ice cream?
I don't eat too much. I make a lot, though, for my son. He eats ice cream. But I do eat. I have about once a week.
Happy Mary Joy.
Which is your favorite of those three? I know it's not Mary because you're a confirmed bachelor, but the other two.
Joy is probably. Okay, things that I'm not looking forward to doing is waiting in the line again to go into World of Disney.
You realize that line was less than 5 minutes.
The line when we were in it was less than 5 minutes, yes. Now the line is probably longer than that because we do such a good job live streaming that everybody wants to follow us.
Is this the Wolfgang Puck that's closed, the one on this side?
Yes. That's we'll walk over there after we cut through here.
We can check and see if the Christmas shop is decorated for Christmas.
Oh, that's a good question. So, what could be one of the cutest pins ever made?
Really?
It's got Lumpy on it.
Oh, I couldn't. Yes, that is very cute. Okay. That's a good movie.
We have the I Collect pins.
Which you do. That's meta.
Yes, but.
And you do that, collect pins.
I do collect pins. Which I will be coming back and possibly purchasing a Lumpy pin.
Appropriate.
What?
Nothing.
Earl of Sandwich.
Is that place still hopping? I mean, that place was always hopping.
Earl? Yeah. Very much. I have definitely seen it on days when I've come down here where there isn't a single person out here, but for some reason, again, Monday at one something or other, it is definitely a hopping place.
They have some sandwiches that are, I'm a vegetarian, and they have some sandwiches that are crazy. The Caprese they have there, the hot Caprese is, whew.
One of the original shops that was the Mickey's Pantry. Now it is the Spice and Tea.
So I remember when I was living there, the Spice and Tea was just like this tiny little section of it. It's like the whole store now?
It is the whole store.
That's awesome. I'm glad they've done so well.
And there is Wolfgang Puck's.
Goodbye. But the dining room remains open on the other side.
Correct. And the quick service. Okay, so we're going to see. We're going to check if the Christmas store is decorated for Christmas.
Joy to you. Joy to you.
And to you. So I would like to point out something that this mural was definitely done in the 90s and has not been updated. So
it features that brand new release Aladdin on it?
Well, everything in here features, you know, the great stuff. But on the ninth day of Christmas, my trio gave me 9 genies flying. So we have the genie sleeping, the genie with mistletoe, the genie with ugly sweater throwing snowballs, and genie sleeping, dreaming of harem girls, Santa genie, reindeer genie, wreath genie, chef genie, and present genie.
Just need to make a note, because that will make a great segment to pull out for some future date. Not to make fun of you, like, just, I really like that. I don't know what we got to do something with. That was really cool.
We could probably cover the different murals in this shop. But it is kind of difficult to get, like, without guests, because on the seventh day of Christmas, my trio gave me 7 dwarves of mining. And it is the dwarves mining.
So have these always been here?
They have.
So I used to run a shopping service. I have been in this store perhaps 500 times, perhaps 5,000 times. Never noticed this stuff.
Yeah. It does not smell like pine as much as it used to in here. But they do have the murals. I actually don't know if they have all 12 of the murals still up.
Wow, I'm so embarrassed. It's not like me to overlook stuff.
But we are.
What's in the side segment there where they kind of change what goes in there? Oh, we actually have a request for information. Do they have the gingerbread plushie keychains? Victory K would like to know.
I have seen them, but I have not seen them down here today.
Keep a weather eye out. So what is this section right now?
Nightmare Before Christmas, Halloween, and Haunted Mansion.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Oh.
A new talent discovered.
I can... Whoa. Okay, just walked into the windstorm again. So I think we'll cut into Art of Disney and then may cut it off so I can go enjoy the line again.
If we could keep you live long enough to go back to the spice rack, there's something you wanted to check for there. They have a Republic of Tea Mandalorian set. I believe I'm reading that right.
Oh, we'll head over there. But I would also like to point out that the mural that had not been changed for nearly 3 years was changed for Freeform Halloween and is now changed for Freeform 25 Days of Christmas. Shall we skip the Art of Disney and just head back to the Spice and Tea Rack?
So I think that's safe. Let's get a quick look at the alligator on our way back. And then we're going to check and see if it has. We don't know that they're supposed. They're not supposed to have it. They may have it, and we'd like to go see.
Okay. Can you see the alligator from here?
No, but that's okay. I can see the elephant. That's even better.
He's way down there on that side.
Goofy Candy Company. Oh, that place is so good. I love that place.
I've not had a glacier from there in so long. Like, my automatic go-to would be the banana every time I'd come down here.
So the gingerbread plushie keychain, she said they were sold out at Downtown Disney as of yesterday. So I don't know if they have them at Disney Springs. Jeremiah says he's seen them, but not necessarily today. And obviously check Shop Disney as well, because so much of the park merchandise is now available on Shop Disney. And, you know, if you want to use a link from our site, we wouldn't mind.
And remember, just because it's sold out on the first day of the merchandise release does not mean in 2 days or 3 days or the day before Christmas that there is tons of it.
So,
okay, I'm looking for Mandalorian stuff.
Yes, it is. It is, quote, Republic of Tea Mandalorian set. I think if you see something Mandalorian, that'd be a good clue.
Yes.
Does it smell like tea in here?
Very much so.
Like a Darjeeling, a green. What do you got?
Well, here, let's choose. What shall we smell? Shall we smell ginger or cinnamon ground or?
I've exhausted my tea knowledge by saying Darjeeling.
This is one of those underrated stores. If you like tea or spices, this is a shop to come to.
So they literally sell spices. Like you can come here and buy your cumin or your cumin.
I was waiting to see how far you can go with that. I got sugar. Oh, peppermint patty sugar for you, Doobie.
Yeah, disgusting.
And they also do have a tea bar.
Oh, lovely. Like, and then you can buy tea?
Yes.
Can you give me a nest tea with sweet and low?
Hang on, let's see. Not nest tea. Not nest tea. Not nest tea. I do not see any Darjeeling
or Mandalorian. Okay, that's okay. I'm glad we came in here. I was not even aware of this shop, so I'm very happy we came in here. This worked out well.
If I stand here, though, it sounds like I'm in a concert.
Yeah, I think we've already gotten copyright for being in here, but that's okay.
Yeah, seriously, on that one. here's Universal Studios. The oldest water fountains here at Disney Springs.
Wow. Literally. Do they still have the Christmas, if you keep walking that way, like the stand up to take your picture in front of a snowman?
Yes, but it is actually, I don't know if it's closed off. For the drop off over here,
the drop off
is closed off. Yes, the I'm gonna touch the butt.
The second best live show in Disney history.
What's the first?
Toy Story the Musical.
Oh, that's right.
That's why we're here. That's why we're here.
Yes, they still have the stand-up, but that area they use for drop-off of vehicles and guests. Well, they don't just drop off vehicles. So some of it is blocked off because you have to walk around to get your temperature checked.
Okay, so, of course.
Since we are on Mandalorian Monday, let's head in and see if any new shipments have come from off planet to the Star Wars trading post for the wrap up of today.
This is Rebecca in studio, and I just have to say rock.
That was for this. Candelorian scented candles, Sandalorian summer footwear. I should be hired by Disney products at once. You should. Fandalorian.
Isn't that the name of our website, Fandalorian?
Yes. Yes, it is. So we are now in the Disney Tales, right?
Yes.
The Pooh Shop?
The where you get $5 bags of stuff.
Well, they're now $9.
All of this stuff is now available on Shop Disney. Links are available on laughingplace.com. Please.
Those little creatures you were just looking at, like the Lando and stuff, do they have Maz and Boba Fett?
They do not.
Okay.
Nope, that was one of the reasons why I was walking in here, was to check if they had gotten the new shipments.
You and the princess on the same page. Kind of makes me wonder why we have a middleman sometimes.
One of the best shirts I want to say ever made.
Really?
I own it, so yes, I like it a lot. So what's your favorite droid, Doobie? A Gonk droid?
I went off the board with Twiggy, but of these, I would go with The classic R2-D2.
Chopper.
Chopper, what's he from?
Rebels. Okay, so it doesn't look like they've received any of the shipments from Batuu here.
Okay, well, it's been quite an afternoon. Just hit an hour, perfect time. We've just crossed an hour. You've done quite a long trip here. So why don't we wrap this up? Is that okay with you, Jeremiah?
Absolutely.
Quick reminder, in 3 short hours, we will have Mando Monday with Rebecca and Mike Celestino, Star Wars Mike. In addition to looking at the new merchandise for Mando Monday, they're going to do a deep dive on episode 1 of Mandalorian, chapter 9, The Marshal. And I am very much looking forward to listening to that. And then this afternoon at 4 o'clock, because it's Monday, we'll have Disney Park Talk Live with myself, Jeremiah, Rebecca, and Mike Celestino. So we've got a busy quattro today. And then at 7:30 p.m., oh my, what a day, we've got Disney Movie Club, Elfie Movie Club with The Sorcerer's Apprentice, starring Nick Cage. And among the panel tonight will be Rebecca as well. She's doing the 4th today.
I thought Nick Cage was on it. That's
running the car wash, as they say. Jeff saw you in the mirror. You went to black. So, Jeff, one Jeremiah sign up for a day. Thanks, Jeremiah. I think we'll be seeing you soon, I'm sure. I think tomorrow you're from Disney Hollywood Studio at the same time, so that'll be fun.
Yep.
Thank you for
visiting. Yeah, let's end on, you know, one of the few fun photo spots still available here at Disney Springs.
Can you hover the camera and go sit there?
Yes, if you not comply, we'll be asked to leave.
No.
Okay. Please,
cover your mouth and nose when coughing and sneezing.